Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Share and Knowledge Video Tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix Windows 10 or Windows 11 startup problems using automatic repair from Advanced Startup. If you have Windows startup problem, if you think the issue has been caused by installing system upgrade, driver updates or wrong settings, Advanced System Recovery Options is the useful way to repair in the Windows startup. You can choose one of the following four recovery options: startup repair, previous build, system restore, reset this PC. First, try the startup repair option in the Advanced Startup. If this does not resolve the issue, or if you have to automatically troubleshoot additional issues, then you can follow these solutions. That is what we are going to do. So watch the video and subscribe channel. Okay. First of all, you need to access the Advanced Startup options. You have three ways for this. Okay. Let's start. Firstly, restart your PC or laptop. Then quickly press Escape key with restart. It will show you a list of options associated with different keys. Then press F11 key to access the Advanced System Recovery options. Secondly, if you can access the sign-in screen of Windows, then on the sign-in screen, click on the power icon. Hold down the Shift key when you click on the power button in the bottom right corner of the Windows login screen, and while holding the key till select restart option. This will open Advanced System Recovery options. Okay. Third one, if you have bootable flash drive or DVD, insert on your PC and then press Enter to run the boot disk. Then you will see the installation window. Then click on Next button. Here you will see the link Repair Your Computer. Click on it. It will open Advanced System Recovery options. Windows Startup Repair is the very first method using in the Advanced Startup options. This will fix any problem that your system may face while booting. You run Windows Startup Repair to fix the problem. Now in the Advanced Startup, select the Troubleshoot option and then choose Advanced Options. In the Advanced Options, choose Startup Repair. Then you will be asked to select your account and then verify your account using your password. If you don't have password, click on continue. After this process, Windows Startup Repair will start diagnosing your PC. This should most probably fix any startup issue you face. Keep in mind, this method will only fix any issue you face during the startup. If your Windows 10 PC does not have a startup problem, it will also show a message Startup Repair could not repair your PC. Okay, that's it. If this method does not work for you, follow the next method. Solution 2, go back to the previous build. Now in the Advanced Startup, select the Troubleshoot option and then choose Advanced option. In the Advanced options, choose Go back to the previous build. Then you will be asked to select your account and then verify your account using your password. If you don't have password, click on continue. After that, Windows previous build will start getting ready to go to the previous build. This should most probably fix any startup issue you face. Keep in mind, this method will only fix any issue you face during the startup. If your Windows 10 PC does not have a startup problem, it will also show a message, we could not find a previous build to take you back to try resetting your current build instead. Okay, that's it. If this method does not work for you, follow the next method. Solution 3, fix a startup problem using system restore. Windows restore is another useful way to repair Windows 10 or 11 using in the Advanced Startup options. Using Windows restore, you can revert to when your Windows was working without any problem. However, to continue with this method, you need to have created a restore point earlier. If you have not created a restore point earlier, this method does not work for you. If you have created a restore point and you want to restore your PC, then you can follow these steps. Okay, let's start. Now in the Advanced Startup Recovery options, select the Troubleshoot option and then choose Advanced options. In the Advanced options, choose System Restore. Then you will see this kind of window, Restore System Files and Settings. Click on Next. Then you will have to select the restore point to which you want to revert back to. After selecting the restore point, click on Next. You can see this link Scan for the affected program. This will show you what program will be added to your system or what program will be removed. If you want, you can do it as you wish. Click on Finish. Then you will receive a warning message. Then click on Yes. This process will restore and reboot your PC. After for a while, once the process is completed, click on Restart. This will reboot your PC. You are done. Next, solution 4, fix a startup problem using reset this PC. in the advanced startup recovery options. If any of the previous method did not work for you, then reset this PC is the last available option for you. Resetting will remove all the data on your PC. So ensure that you have a backup before you continue resetting your PC to repair Windows 10 or 11. Keep in mind, before you get started, reset this PC. Make sure you have a power backup. Okay, let's see how to reset this PC. Now in the advanced startup recovery options, select the troubleshoot option and then choose reset this PC. Then select remove everything. You can choose an option as you wish. Then after for a while, select fully clean the drive. It will reset fresh Windows. You can choose an option. After for a while, click on reset. This will start resetting your PC. Your PC might restart several times during the process. Be patient, this process will take some time. Once the process is completed, you will have to set up Windows. Once you do that, you will be able to use your PC without any problem. Before you get started, reset this PC. Make sure you have a power backup. Next, fix Windows 10 11 startup problems with command prompt. If you have Windows startup problem, if you think there is an issue has been caused by the corrupted system files, otherwise, if you think there is an issue with the master boot record on your PC, to fix the problem following four solutions, you should be tried. Okay, let's start. Solution number one, run SFC scan using command prompt on safe mode. Okay, let's start. In the advanced startup options, select the troubleshoot option and then choose advanced options. In the advanced options, choose startup settings and then click on restart to restart your PC. When your PC restarts, you will see a list of options. You will get the options to enable safe mode with command prompt here. Press 6 key on the keyboard to run the command prompt as an administrator with safe mode. Then you will be asked to select your account and then verify your account using your password. If you don't have password, click on continue. In the command prompt window, type this command SFC space / scan now and hit enter to execute it. Now beginning system scan. This process will take some time. This will fix any corrupted files that might be causing the problem on your computer. That's it. Once complete, type exit and hit enter to close command prompt window to continue to your Windows. Now check if this helps or not. If this method does not work for you, follow the next method. Solution number two, fix startup problem with chkdsk command. Chkdsk examines disk space and disk usage and provides a status report specific to each file system. If used with the /F, /R, /X or /B parameters, it fixes errors on the volume. Okay, let's start. In the advanced startup options, select the troubleshoot option and then choose advanced options. In the advanced options, choose command prompt. When you see that command prompt has opened on your computer, in the command prompt window, simply type this command chkdsk space /F space D column and press enter. Generally, it is the C drive. In my case, D drive is the operating system drive. Type your operating system drive letter and press enter. It will fix errors on the volume. Okay. Once complete, type exit and hit enter to close the command prompt. Then return to the troubleshooting window. Click on continue to normally boot into Windows without getting any errors. It will reboot your operating system. Now check if this helps or not. If this method does not work for you, follow the next method. Solution number 3. Recreate the EFI directory structure and reconfigure the boot file using bcd boot command. In the advanced startup options, select the troubleshoot option and then choose advanced options. In the advanced options, choose command prompt. Then you will be asked to select your account and then verify your account using your password. If you don't have password, click on continue. When you see that command prompt has opened on your computer, type these commands. Type the command disk path and hit enter. Then type the command list disk and hit enter. Then select disk 0. You select hard disk where 0 stands for the boot drive. Type select disk 0 and hit enter. Then type the command list vol and hit enter. This will display the volumes of all attached disks on your PC. Now here you need to select the volume which your system reserved recovery EFI partition. EFI means it means extensible firmware interface. Okay, volume number 1 is the Windows installed drive. Volume number 2 is the system reserved recovery drive. Then select your volume. In my case, volume 2 is the system reserved EFI partition. Type the command select volume 2 and hit enter. Now you need to assign a new drive letter to the EFI partition. Type the command assign space letter is equal to V column and hit enter. Then you should see disk path assign the drive letter successfully. Then type exit and press enter to exit the disk path. After that, type the command V column and hit enter. Now you need to create the EFI directory structure with the command. Type the command md space backslash EFI backslash Microsoft backslash boot backslash and hit enter. Then change to the boot directory. Type the command cd space forward slash d space v column backslash EFI backslash Microsoft backslash boot backslash and hit enter. Then type the command bootrec space forward slash fix boot and hit enter. Then you should see operation completed successfully. After that, type the command bcd boot space c column backslash windows space forward slash l space en dash us space forward slash s space v column space forward slash f space all and hit enter. This command will repair your bootloader. Then you should see boot files successfully created. Operation completed successfully. Then type exit and hit enter to close command prompt. Then return to the troubleshooting window. Click on continue to normally boot into Windows 10 without getting any errors. It will reboot your operating system. Okay. Now check if this helps or not. Solution 4. Fix your startup problem with bootrec commands. In the advanced startup options, select the troubleshoot option and then choose advanced options. In the advanced options, choose command prompt. Then you will be asked to select your account and then verify your account using your password. If you don't have password, click on continue. When you see that command prompt has opened on your computer, then type these bootrec commands. To do that, type the command bootrec space forward slash fix mbr and hit enter. Then you should see operation completed successfully. Then type bootrec space forward slash fix boot and hit enter. Then you will see operation completed successfully. If you have message fix boot access is denied, then type boot sect space forward slash nt60 space sys and hit enter. then you should see boot code was successfully updated all targeted volumes. Then again type bootrec space /fix boot and hit enter. Then you should see operation completed successfully. Type /export /C:\BCD backup and hit enter. Then you should see operation completed successfully. Then type /boot /BCD -H -R -S and hit enter. Then type run /en/C:\BOOT/BCD -BCD.OLD and hit enter. Then type bootrec /rebuild BCD and hit enter. This will scan all disks for installations that are compatible with Windows. Additionally, it lets you select the installations that you want to add to the BCD store. Total identified Windows installations 1D:\Windows. Here asking add installations to boot list. Type yes. Why? Then you should see operation completed successfully. By doing this, you make sure that the BCD store is completely rebuilt. Type exit and hit enter to close command prompt. Then return to the troubleshooting window. Click on continue to normally boot into Windows without getting any errors. It will reboot your operating system. Okay, I hope this video helped for you. Thanks for watching and supporting. If you have any issues, so please let me know in the comment section below. Your contribution is more confidence. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel for more useful videos. Once again, thanks for watching and supporting. See you next video. Bye. Take care.